Unfortunately, for Marisol and I, our unlikely journey was fraught with roadblocks. The biggest being the fight to have our names on the ballot, which is a matter of voting rights. And we weren't the only ones to legally challenge the ballot. There were two other suits filed, and these legal challenges leave the outcome of this election vulnerable to being contested.
That is Valerie Ervin, who announced her withdrawal from the Democratic race for governor today, endorsing Rashern Baker, the Prince George's County executive. C4 joins me now. Let's go to the point that she raised, that you're going to see a contested primary. She had a number of, she had her suit. There were other suits. You have other races where Ted Sophocles in Anne Arundel County is on the ballot. He passed away sadly last week. Nathaniel Oakes is on the ballot. He is awaiting sentencing. What about this election getting contested?
Well, a few of those are a little different. When it comes to Nathaniel Oakes, he tried to get his name removed from the ballot, and for whatever reason, the rules said he couldn't. It wasn't an issue of time or anything like that. The argument being made by the Board of Elections and Linda Lamone was the fact that they had a time element associated with removing the name of Kevin Kamenetz. Look, Prince George's County Executive Rashern Baker III and Valerie Ervin just joined me on the show, and Prince George's Executive Baker said if he's governor, he will make sure that the Board of Elections has the capabilities, no matter what the time frame is, to remove candidates in a similar emergency type of situation. He said he was outraged that they could not, in 2018, with the technology available, be able to change ballots. We're talking about something that, really, in my mind, Robert, having done this a lot, I don't understand how we can't do that.
Sure.
Valerie, a judge understood, but I don't understand.
Valerie Ervin endorsing Rashern Baker, her former employer, endorsed Ben Jealous. And
correct.
There have been reports that Ben Jealous tried to dissuade Valerie Ervin from becoming Kevin Kamenetz's running mate.
Oh, you mean went to Kevin Kamenetz? Her accusation, yeah. Valerie Ervin's, is she actually Jealous went to Kamenetz and tried to stop
it. Don't pick her.
I asked Valerie Ervin about that, and she said her deciding to endorse for Rashern Baker, that played no role. Ben Jealous's involvement, I'm sure you believe that, played no role at all in this. But her point was is that Rashern Baker, to her, has the executive experience that's needed right now. As a matter of fact, she said he doesn't have to read in a book about governing. He's actually done it. Those were her words.
So in the poll, polls, Valerie Ervin got anywhere from 7 to 9%.
Does third
that
or fourth. She
go
was third or fourth,
pretty much on. Now to
no.
Baker?
No, it doesn't. I believe what you're going to see, though, in the Montgomery County area, Robert, is that 2 or 3% maybe that Rashern Baker needs to at least get him in a position where if he picks up anything else from some of the other jurisdictions, it separates him from what is right now a too close to call race between him and Ben Jealous. But I really believe her endorsement is important in Montgomery County, in the Prince George's area, for that sliver, that 2 to 3% sliver.
Very quickly, Baltimore Sun endorses Ben Jealous for governor. Washington Post endorses Rashern Baker. Is this just a case of
regional battle, man.
Regional battle, yeah.
And I think that the Baltimore Sun picked Ben Jealous, even though he's not necessarily a Baltimore native.
Right.
His parents are from here.
His grandparents are from here.
And my family's known his family for years. But really, there is no, think about it, no really Baltimore area-centric candidate. Of course, you have Jim Shea and you have Alec. But I'm talking about in the dominant part of the race. Kevin Kamenetz was that. Kevin Kamenetz was that candidate. He's now gone. So I think the Baltimore Sun's endorsement is almost a de facto endorsement to Ben Jealous because of County Executive Kamenetz kind of not being there.
C4 Encore tonight at 11:35. C4's back tomorrow, 9 to 1 on WBAL News Radio 1090.